Merryn looked in awe all around her. She knew this place from her father's songs. These were the lost ruins of the Merrows. Blocked Merryn's path. Although the creatures could be deadly to the touch, they were very shy and even avoided each other's light.
Thank you.
shuddered, as if recovering from a bad dream. For a moment, she thought she had experienced her own death, but it had merely been the tyne showing her one of the many possible roads ahead. Blocked Merryn's path. Although the creatures could be deadly to the touch, they were very shy, and even avoided each other's light. Discovered two glowing lights amidst the scraps of an old Fomori machine. She attached them to the front of the submarine's hull, hoping they would help guide her on her journey. A blur of colour darted through the shadows. Was that a Merrow maiden swimming through the ruins? Peered through the windows of the houses, wondering if a Merrow girl once lived there, and if her father had sung her lullabies about the world above. Merryn tried to speak to her, but the Merrow raced away. Darted through the shadows. Was that a Merrow maiden swimming through the ruins? tried to speak to her, but the Merrow raced away.
Thank you.
The razor-quilled pufferfish was not a direct threat, but it steadfastly refused to move out of the way. Swirl in the water tugged at Merryn's sub. Was this a tyne vortex? Where might it lead? At last, the Merrow Maiden stopped. Merryn called to her.
Please wait. I'm only trying to find my father.
The Merrow looked at her for a long moment, then stirred the water with her hands, forming a ghostly image. It was the sunken ship graveyard known as Skeleton Reef. Could her father be trapped there? The Merrow pointed the way to go, and Merryn thanked her. Before she turned to go, Merryn asked the Merrow her name.
Call me Kara, she said. Another girl once called me that, years ago. She said it means friend.
Graveyard of ships, Merryn would have to cross the foul and treacherous region known as Watcher's Hollow. This was a place her father had never sung about, for the tales of the Watcher were known only to those below. Cuttlepops swam through the dark caverns, heedless of their deadly surroundings. Maybe they were tougher than they looked. Even the stinging anemones seemed to avoid them. spilled out into a great, open expanse of water. The howls of hungry leviathans echoed in the distance. This seemingly bottomless trench was known as the Maw.